I've done some little workshops, presentations, especially in schools, elementary schools. I ask the people to do is to look around the room and find something that did not go through the hands of an artist other than people. And it's just virtually impossible.
Well, I love the guy, and I've known him for so many years, and he's so talented, and I just thought he deserved some recognition for all the wonderful things he's done.
I've always made pictures from age 3, 4, 5 on, and so it's like another language for me, and it's just normal for me to be interested in drawing and painting and other people's drawing and painting and the design of buildings and the general, you know, clothing and so forth. So it's just part of me.
When I first saw this picture, it just absolutely took my breath away. Obviously, I'd heard the name. We've got his other paintings and pictures around City Hall. I'm aware of his work up at Crittenton. But actually, to get up to stand up here, look at the painting, and actually just talk to him about the passion that he put into it and the research, absolutely incredible, the work he did on this singular painting. But really, though this is a large work, all of his work really has a touch of love, a touch of love for the city, for the building. And I think you really see it in each works that you can you see of his.
Well, I think it's had a large impact because it's very historical things he's done. He's done so many buildings and this mural you see behind me here. And he's done so many things, and he's done it without remuneration. He's just so generous.
This depicts City of Rochester approximately in the year 1900. It was definitely a factory town. The biggest factory, of course, being the knitting mill. The river, Clinton River, was crossed with a very rickety trestle. There were two major hotels in town, the Detroit Hotel, but you'll see each hotel had a livery stable where you could rent a horse while you were staying. There were two railroads coming into town. And because there were two railroads, that contributed to the rapid growth of the village of Rochester. This body of water over here is Chapman Pond, which was used, you can see all the tributaries there, was used to provide water power to all the mills. And the library and post office are located right there in the middle of the pond. You can see the Harrison School, which was the Rochester High School at the time. There are a few buildings in the picture that are still there, mainly the ones along Main Street, pretty much unchanged to this day. But everything else was different.
For the city of Rochester, art and culture is just extremely important for our town. It's a historic town settled in 1817, and throughout its entire history, we've had wonderful contributors to our community, from the architecture to downtown, the beautiful way our parks align with our rivers. I think that inspires individuals to create really good art and just establishes a culture that's been, you know, 200 years deep in the city of Rochester.
Sadly enough, the horse that pulled this little buggy here has since passed away.
His work is important to the community because it's history.
I think Rochester is a very upscale community, and I think art and culture is very important to our residents. And I think that's one of the things that really makes Rochester what it is, to have art, to have things to do, to have places for people to really feel like they're a community.
It all started sort of by chance when Ruth Collins asked me to do a drawing and a print of an historic Rochester scene. And through the years, I've enjoyed every single one.
As a teacher myself, I understand Jerry's worked hard with helping out kids who had issues and problems and used art to tutor those people. So I think that's just a great asset to our community.
He works with children in Pontiac. I think he still does, and he's done that for years. And I just thought he should be nominated.
We live within walking distance of the library. And one afternoon I took my two little granddaughters down there. We walked down. And on the way, I said hello to a lot of people. And when we got to the library, the people were saying, "Hello, Mr. Post, how are you?" and so forth. And my little granddaughter looked up at me and said, "Grandpa, you know everybody."
On behalf of Rochester and our city council and the people of Rochester, I want to congratulate Jerry Post. Just an outstanding citizen. He's done great work in our town. And on behalf of everybody in Rochester, I want to congratulate Jerry on this great award.